Welcome everybody, you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Today we're going to do some exploratory data analysis, panda plotting, and some multi-indexed tables. I decided to do this video because I've noticed lately I've had some people who are very new to Python, and I thought this would be something very useful for them. As always, feel free to hit me up here on Instagram and Twitter. And if you'd like to help support this channel, feel free right here. Let's get into this. You want to follow along. The data came from Kaggle right here. You could download the data set or go on my GitHub as usual where I post all my code. It'll be in the link in the description below. Here's your imports. Let's evaluate this data real quick and see what we're actually dealing with. This is some sales data, and some of the columns that we're going to be interested in first will be sales, subcategory, category, as well as the postal information, the state, and then the segment that you're going to see here, as well as shipping mode, which is this as well. All right, so let's zoom in just a little bit. So we'll notice that we want to create some plotting from pandas directly. While these aren't publication quality plots, we will be able to see a few things. So let's block out some of this real quick so we can see what's going on here. So what I did was I took two columns of interest, which were your shipping mode and your sales. And I decided to do a group by your shipping mode and then sum along all of the sales relating to each one of those modes. And then I sorted the values in descending order. And let's look at this real fast. So here's what we're dealing with in descending order for our sales. Standard shipping, second class, first class, and same day. You'll notice the standard shipping turned out to be the highest sales because it's the cheapest. Now, how would you actually enter inside of this table? Let's look at this real quick. If you've never done this before, let's find out what the columns are. The columns are sales. Well, then what is the other information that we're dealing with? It's called an index, and the index is all of our row indexes that we were just looking at. Let's get into the plotting of this. So let's scroll back up and let's undo all of this and plot it out and see what it looks like. Before we scroll down, let me explain what's going on. I decided to just do a regular plot, increase the font size, the figure size, and rotate the labels, or the X tick values by 50 degrees. Then I set an X label. I create a grid pattern, which you're going to see, the Y label, and then the title for the plot. And then I just print it off again, the table information, so you can see it. So here's our table. And here's our plotting. Let's look at this a little better. So here's our plotting, which is our sales on the Y versus each one of the modes of shipping. Okay, so you'll see that the standard shipping has the highest sales, and then it goes down from there for the more expensive shipping. From there, we'll look at doing a separate table, but we're gonna set it up a little bit differently with this plot. So instead, we're gonna have two columns with our index of shipping mode. This is pretty cool because now we're able to see how much money did they make for each shipping type, and then how many people actually use this, like how many packages accounted for standard class shipping, how many accounted for second class shipping, etc. So we did this with the group by relative to our shipping mode. Then we're calling our sales and running an aggregate on this, an aggregate function, allowing us to do two separate operations here. Then we just sorted these values in descending order again, ran a plot, and I didn't have any parameters inside of here. And then I just printed off the table, and I didn't put anything inside of here to show you next. So we scroll down, and I didn't play with any of the functionality here on purpose because this count right here, while it would have been useful if it was on a different scaling, you know, since all the values were fairly similar, it just looks like a straight line. This would be relevant if you had some data that were on a different scale, so you would have been able to plot two different variables at the same time with respect to whatever you're having on your x-axis. So this is pretty useful. Then what we'll do is something a little similar, but we're going to use the aggregate and basically take the count, which is this length, and we're going to unnest everything. So what does this even look like if we're doing this with a table? Let's even look at it without that. So here's with this table nested, where we're looking at by the segment type, if for a corporation or is it for a home office, and then what shipping type and how many items were shipped with respect to consumer for first, second, same day, and standard class shipping. So now we'll do our plotting and see what this looks like, where I had to rotate the labels. And I did a bar plot. And if you notice, we do a subplot equals true. Scroll down, and we'll see that we're going to have four plots. which is pretty cool because it's with respect to each of the three types, consumer, corporate, and office. And within each one of those, you have your standard, second class, same day, first class shipping. And you'll notice that each one of the y-axis are consistent with the count values for each one of those classes. The next thing we can do is a bar chart, allowing us to do the same thing, but with respect to the bars here, and you're going to see something interesting. So this is a pretty simple plot. You could do the same thing, but set it up as a bar chart. And that's what's going on with this. And all we did was change up the labels. So here you go with this. This is a little bit more readable, where we have on the y-axis the quantity sold, and then we scroll down and we can see that we're grouping by consumer, corporate, and office type. And for each one of those, we have with respect to the first class, same day, second day, and standard shipping. So this is very useful and intuitive to interpret. So here we're doing our subcategory sales in US dollars, where, let's make this a little more legible for us, where we're taking our data, subsetting within two particular columns that we want, and running a group by function and summing each one of the categories by their sales, sorting it in descending order as usual, and running a bar chart. And then we just chuck in here all of our label information that we're doing, which is fairly simple. These are all pretty much the same kind of idea when you're plotting this. So we'll scroll down and look at on the y-axis, we have our sales information in descending order relative to each subcategory for our sales information. We can use a cross tab, which is interesting because you don't need a data frame. You can use an array or a list instead, and you have the option of normalizing your data as well, which is different than a pivot table. So I decided to subset my data and arbitrarily convert it into a NumPy array instead of a data frame or a pandas series, so you can see what I'm talking about. Let's look at this real quick. So just here's what our data looks like for our subcategory names. Let's run our crosstab real quick, and you'll see that for your indexes, we have all of our subcategories here. And then going along this column, we have the actual count number that this particular person purchased 0 accessories. They purchased 1 piece of artwork, 1 bookcase. This person purchased 1 piece of accessories, 1 piece of artwork, etc. So this is a useful little table. The next thing that we can work with is nesting further to show our sales information by count relative to the customer and the subcategory that we just showed above, doing it this way with a group by instead. We need to take these particular columns with all rows and do a group by relative to the person's name and their category here, which are our index values, and our column, which is going to be our sales, but this is going to be a count instead, which is this. This is doing the same thing, just set up differently. So we could scroll down, perform another cross tab, where this is going to have an index of our customer name, which is here, and then we're taking our columns, which are our subcategories, and then we're taking the values from the sales, and that's going to be these right here, and then I'm using the sum for each of the sales. You could do the mean, you could do whatever you want there. So you have a lot of functionality. So we're still using the people. So for each person, they bought a piece of art, which was almost $18. And remember from above, they only had 1 item. The next thing we could do, we could look at another crosstab example to get a little more functionality. This one's relatively simple, where we're only looking at, after we subset Florida, then we'll do a crosstab where the city is the index value and the category or subcategory for our items is going to be our index. So we scroll down and we can see that in the city of Apopka, we have 1 item sold. In Boca Raton, we have 1 binder. In Apopka, we have 3 binders, etc. Let's do something so we could have some plotting with a bar chart. And we're going to take the cross tab for the cities in Florida and look at the subcategories here. And we're going to do a stacked equals true. And you'll see why in a second. This is just plug and chug, and we're doing a bar chart. So we scroll down, I gotta zoom out, and we're gonna see. We have all of our categories along this legend. We have on the y-axis all of our quantities sold. And then on the X tick marks, we have each city in Florida. There's like 36, I think. And you'll be able to see what was sold within each one of those cities, quantity-wise. Pivot tables, but if you set them up right, you could have a pivot table form the same layout as a crosstab. So in this case, I want the city, state, and sales subset from our data. Then I'm going to do a pivot table where the index position is our state and our city, and the actual values are the sales. And we're going to take the mean for those. Index of state followed by city and the mean sales for that city. This is a pretty useful option that you have. We could then do a little bit of fun and take our Florida data once again and play around with this. So let's do another plot. First, we're going to do a pivot table where we're taking the city and the subcategory as our index. Sales is going to be the columns, and then we're going to use the mean of those. So in the city of Apopka, they sold $671.50 on average for appliances. That's how you would interpret this. Now let's do some plotting with these data. We're going to take the same thing that we just did above. We're going to plot it, but we're going to sort the values in descending order for the sales, do a bar chart, rotate the labels, play with the sizes of the figure and the font, and chuck in our label information here. And this is what you end up with. We have our sales on the y-axis for every single county in descending order for our bar chart. And that'll be the conclusion of this video. I hope it brought utility to someone, but please like, share, and subscribe. And if you subscribe, turn on that notification bell. Feel free to hit me up right here on Instagram and Twitter. And if you would like, help support this channel on Buy Me a Coffee. There's my handle. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.